Did you know caribou moss is not actually a moss but a lichen? I bet you did, because you're all very beautiful, intelligent people. And you should like my video. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is BestInSlot with the final episode of our little Tyto Ecology Dinosaur DLC experiment kind of a thing. Now, as you can see, I've got a lot of points. A lot of time has passed since last episode, folks. We're talking like a decade or something. The first thing we're going to do is head over to Muntjac and take a little look at how this guy's doing. This one is the one that I started to build. I just kind of wanted to build an ecosystem full of life and full of plants without any dinosaurs yet. You know, it's completely open. And every time I log onto it, it gives me a buttload of points as well, which is pretty handy. As you see, it's kind of working. It's starting to spread. Every time I log on, the jungle spreads a little bit further, you know, and nothing has taken over quite like those bloody flowers. This, for me, is going to be our perfect ecosystem, you know. This is where we're going to build in a little bit, like, how we'd actually want it to turn out. It's just, it's all spreading nicely. It all looks pretty good. Yeah. The one thing I have to make sure I keep doing is adding in zangs towards the edges to make sure, you know, they can actually spread that far. And whilst we've got, oh, actually what we should do as well, unlock zone 5. I've already done this on the other one. We don't actually have any need for T-points now other than speeding up time and getting some more points, so we may as well use them. But yeah, I've really just tried to keep it very varied in terms of plant life and stuff, as you can kind of tell. It's beautiful, right? I mean, it's really nice. There may be a few too many platinuses that start to spread a little bit crazily. I think we need to add something else over here. Otherwise, it's just going to be platinus and cycads and whatever the hell these are called. Dipteris, that's the one. So let's add some stuff over here. Maybe some ferns. Ferns are nice just to... there's already a few over here anyway, but just some little things just to kind of populate the ground with stuff. Yeah, some equisetum. These things seem to spread quite quickly, so I'm a little bit more worried about putting loads of those in. I want some trees as well. Let's get some trochos in there. They're nice. You kind of need this nice balance between big, little, and moderately big, you know? Just like with a penis. Right, I think the only one of the ones I've neglected is the magnos. We'll have to go do a little bit of those. But what I want over here, let's do a ginkgo forest because they're freaky. Yeah, awesome. Right, so, yeah, and let's go back to the reason I've spent so much time working on that one, on Muntjac, to make it as good as possible and make it look a nice, pretty little biome, is because this one that we're about to look at, I Like Dinos, is a goddamn disaster. Right, here we go. Over the last 12 months, you've earned 192. So, oh god. So, as you can see, my plan hasn't really worked. The Oviraptors just keep spreading. Right, and it's spreading further and further and further and further. This is where the Ferrozinosaurus has lived. Now, I wanted to clear that out as well. This looks really nice. But I brought in some Tarbosaurs, which killed the Therizinosaurs, and then died themselves, right? Of course. Like I said, I keep bringing in Raptors, but the Oviraptors, I think there's too many of them now, that it's like literally impossible for me to stop them. So this is basically the world of Oviraptors, and there's pretty much nothing I can do about it anymore. There's one Tarbosaurus chilling here. In theory, the Tarbosauruses and the Velociraptors should keep spreading and spreading until they kill all the Oviraptors, right? But the Oviraptors are all over here. They weren't over here last time I came on. They were over here. That's why there's barely any raptors in this direction, because the Oviraptors didn't get this far. Okay. I'm going to have to believe that I can fix this. The other one is the important one, but we're going to believe, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to believe. Where's my raptors? Do I want to bring in Raptor or do I want to bring in Tarbosaurus? Will Tarbosaurus eat an Oviraptor? It will. It must do, right? Right. We're going to hedge our bets on that. Sort of. And we're going to assume that's the case. And we're going to bring in many, 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 many Tarbosaurus. Many, 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 I mean hundreds of Tarbosauruses. They will kill everything and then they will die themselves because they'll have no food left, and then it'll be done. Okay? Okay. I want to do that a few times because I want to skip forward time when we have tarp sources in place. Other than that, we will skip forward time to get more points. Tarbosaurus, here to save the day by slaughtering everybody. How do you take photos? I've kind of forgot. Gee, that's how you do it. One next photo of my Tarbo. I mean, it's nice having this forest, basically. That's pretty cool. A group of Oviraptor has split again. I really like the environment. I just don't like this horde of Oviraptors. Can you stop moving, please? It's not taking screenshots anymore. It's just hiding the UI. There we go. If I just tap it really quick... Oh, no. Okay, I've broken it again. Okay. Let's wait until we've got enough for one more set of Tarbos. Bring them in. It's hard to find a space for them. And skip forward time. Hopefully, as we skip forward this year, we're going to see a lot of stuff about, you know, the Oviraptors are dying because the Tarbosauruses are eating them alive! Hopefully. There is another unfortunate side effect of this mass Oviraptorness in that the loading times clearly can't handle it at all, and it's gone from relatively stable, very quick loading times to something that takes about 3 minutes. So why don't I have any things? Where's all my territory signs? Okay, well, it looks like there might be less Oviraptors. It's hard to tell, but let's bring up the this thing. Look, why would my Tarbosaurus die? How are you starving? There is so many things for you to eat. Oh, detritus. Where? Zone 4? Over here? Meow. How can Zone 4 have detritus when there's nothing in Zone 4? What was that notification? I need to know. It's just so many of them. I can't bear it anymore. I'm done with this. I'm so done with this one. We're going to the main menu. We're going to build a nice little thing in Muntjac, okay? We're going to have some nice Muntjac time. That's all. I've got lots of points to play with. 370, nice. We can build ourselves a little environment. I want to have a nicely balanced little ecosystem here with every single creature in it. That is the goal, right? That'd be a nice way to finish things off. So, let's think about this. Zalams. My little insectivores. They're going to live... I need somewhere with a high Zang population. Where would they want to live? Probably over around here, right? Zalams are going to live in there. They're going to be feasted upon. I'm going to bring in two of the Zalams. Because they're going to be feasted upon by the Delta Theridiums that live over there. And just to account for that, we'll bring in some extra Zangs as well. Which is good anyway, because it pollinates my plants quicker. So. They're so tiny! Okay. So, Mononychus should be able to live here in relative harmony, but I'm going to bring them somewhere else. The Mononychus is going to live in this little platinus kind of... The problem is the territory is so huge that they kind of just spread out anyway, but they're going to live there. And again, we'll bring in some more Zangs just to make sure they don't run out of food. Protoceratops. This is Protoceratops Island, as per usual. And the Oviraptor is going to eat... The Protoceratops? No. The Saurolophus is going to stomp around. It needs to be somewhere like over here where there's already a lot of plant life. Enough to sustain like a large creature. Points, please. Thank you. I don't want to skip forward time until I've got everything in there. Same with the Gallimimus. They're going to live together. And same with the Nemetosaurus. They're all going to live here in a nice little area. Maybe I'll bring in some Protoceratops as well. Okay, now, this population needs to be kept in check at least somewhat. So, we're going to have a pack of Tarbosauruses that live up here on the hill. And some of these dinosaurs might survive till breeding, some of them won't. I think that's probably likely how it's going to go. Therizinosaurus is going to live a little bit further up in the shadows. And they're going to be left pretty much alone, because Ferris Dinosaurs is awesome, and I don't wish them to die. Although, they can compete with Dino... No, Dino Ferris is going to live over here. The problem is, right, the biome is clearly too small to sustain what I'm trying to do here. It doesn't work, but I'm trying. Bring some raptors. Is that everything? I think that's everything, folks. That's all, folks. Oh, overraptor. Did I bring an overraptor? I don't think so, right? Have I gone crazy? There's a chance. Whatever. There we go. Beautiful. Really wish you could hide the UI. Maybe you can. Where's the options? Controls. Hide UI. Just, no. Well, I mean, sometimes it hides anyway. It's weird, right? Where's my fairies? There they are. Living their lives. I really like the Dinosaurs as well. It's really cool. Right, I'm trying to take a screenshot. Can you wake up for me, son? That would be nice. Cheers. Let me just poke it with the camera. Eh. There we go. See, it works. It's hard to get a good thumbnail screenshot. Stop. It's all about the thumbnail, ladies and gentlemen. It's all about the thumbnail. Okay, it can't be a Ferrisinosaurus again, because we've already done a Ferrisinosaurus. It can't be a Tarbosaurus. It could be you, couldn't it? Oh, look at him walking on his... Oh, God. Oh, I've made a mistake. Adorable. Ah, no. No, no, that was it. I'll just print screen. Okay, right. I think we're good. The jungle is going to keep spreading. All the animals are here, maybe balanced, who knows? Zalalums are dying already. Where are my Zalams? Zalams are over here, right? What are they being eaten by? Are the Delta Theridiums killing them at such a rate that the Zalams are dying out? Maybe the raptors? We're bringing more Zalams. Zalams everywhere! They're only little. There we go, lots of Zalams. There's our forest, populated with actual dinosaurs, for once. Just looks alive. A little proto in there, look at it! It's... Okay, right, let's skip forward time. Boop! And see what's got murdered. Which will likely be most of it. I should get tons of points for you. We've got literally every single thing in the game. Yeah, 189. My diversity score, that must be nearly the most you can get. I don't know whether a diversity score is just how many different species you have or the balance of those species amongst each other, if you know what I mean. Like, if I've got 99 Oviraptors and one Therizinosaurus, is that the same as having one Oviraptor and one Therizinosaurus, you know? Either way, my diversity should be pretty damn near as high as you can get because we've got lots of species and we'll... Oh my god, the Zalams! Oh, what have I done? That was a disaster! An absolute disaster! Oh no! I didn't think they'd spread like that. They were dying the last time I was here. I'm not doing the woman in the bloody shoe again. I am though. Delta Theridiums, you're gonna save the day for me, friends. Okay? That's craziness! I think I brought in too many herbivores as well. I feel like the forest is getting smaller. It's hard to tell, but... The deltas will only eat the Zalams, right? If I just bring in a ton of deltas, they'll eat the Zalams, and then they'll die out themselves. This should be foolproof. In theory. How often do my theories work? Eh, that's another... Doesn't matter, shut up. I can't believe how many... That's crazy! I really didn't expect... I mean, they are... rat-esque creatures, I guess. So, you know, one thing you know about rats, they have a lot of babies. I used to have pet rats, actually. I really like pet rats, but people are always like, eh, rats, but that's stupid, rats are amazing. This is clever. I am the woman with a shoe. No, I ate a spider, okay? I am that woman. We are all that woman today. This was meant to be my perfect ecosystem. Instead, they're dying because they're getting hunted by the Tarbosaurus. The Dinosaurus has only got one left. I think they're all just dying, basically. How's my ferries doing? They're fine. Nobody's gonna hunt my ferries. The other raptors have split, unless I bought in two and didn't realise. Bloody Nora, right. Oh, my Monarchus has split as well. Let's go forward again. This time, it's gonna be perfect, guys. Don't even worry about it. Did you know caribou moss is not actually a moss, but a lichen? I bet you did, because you're all very beautiful, intelligent people. And you should like my video. Oh my god, right. There we go, right, problem sorted. Problem bloody sorted. You can see, right, the Delta Theridiums, there's not that many of them because they've started to die out because they've got nothing to hunt, and all the bloody Zalums are gone, which is good. Protos are dying. Why did the Protos die? Interesting. Yeah, my jungle can't handle this. I really needed a whole map before we got this going. The Mononocuses are spreading at a fairly alarming rate, actually. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 packs of those already. 2 packs of Protos. 4 packs of Deinochirus? 3 packs of Oviraptor. Oh no, there's another Mononocus over there as well. Right, so we need to kill the Mononocus. So, small carnivore. I don't think there is one. I think we just need to bring in some raptors. And that's going to help us sort out the Protoceratops population as well. I'm going to bring in a buttload of raptors. There we go, easy peasy. Man, my poor jungle's getting annihilated. I'm going to bring in a Tarbosaurus as well. Tarbosaurus is like a cleanup crew, you know? By Tarbosaurus, I mean I'm going to bring in several Tarbosauruses. Cleanup crew. Cleanup hype. It's like a bloody interspecies orgy. Right. I don't think I can time skip again after this. It's getting quite expensive. From 75 to 100 to 225. Joshua, trees are tree-like in behavior and looks, but they're actually a member of the yucca. Yeah, no one in my biodome. Oh my god, the detritus. Where's all my jungle gone? Oh no. This has been an absolute disaster, ladies and gentlemen. I don't understand how they ate it so quickly. We'd skipped forward several years and it hadn't been a problem. And then suddenly, was it just the detritus? But I had detritus things in. I had termites in, right? And maybe because this was meant to be my masterpiece. It's a mess. Oh, I'm so bad at this game. Right, we're going to end it there, ladies and gentlemen. I was going to come back and do another episode on this thing, but we clearly can't because I've killed it. No, we'll just... We've had a lot of fun, we've seen every single species in the game, we've had several huge disasters that were completely my fault. You know, what more could you possibly want? This has been Tyto Ecology Dinosaur DLC, I've had a great time, hopefully you guys have had too. Remember to stick around, because on Tuesday, ladies and gentlemen, there is a new-ish Zoo Tycoon game coming out, and we're going to play the bejeebus out of that, so stick around for that. And I shall see you lovely folks in the next episode. If you did like this disaster of a video, please do hit that like button, massively helps me out. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye.